It's your turn. not so certain. All my life I've been torn, but I'm here for a reason. Could it be the reason I was born? I have always been so different. Home rules and not apply. Is this the day? Are you the way? I finally find out why. Show yourself. I'm no longer trembling. Here I am. I've come so far. Are you the one I've been looking for all of my life? Oh, show yourself. Let me see who you are. Come to me now. Open your doors. Don't make me wait one moment more. Oh, come to me now. Open your doors. Don't make me wait one moment more.
Close. Mic here.
Try to remember. remember. And if you remember, then follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember. December, it's nice to remember without a hurt. The heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fires of September that made us mellow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember.
Uphill climb. It's gonna be a tough fight. There's gonna be some lonely nights, but I'm ready to carry on. I'm so glad the worst is over,
'cause it almost took me down.
I can start.
Say to me, and everything you do.
season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've gotta be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Every man has his daydreams. Every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning. Nightingales have their song. Don't you see I want my life to be something more than long.
Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've gotta be where my spirit can run free.
America. Good evening. Please rise for the national anthem. Please be seated. Again, good evening and welcome. As we come together this evening to celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2021, we also remember those who may not be with us this evening, whose presence has helped shape us, been a significant part of our life. Especially when we reach important milestones such as these, we remember all those who have had positive effect on who we have become. As the principal of Fayetteville-Manlius High School, and on behalf of our superintendent, Dr. Tice, the Board of Education, I am pleased to welcome the families and guests of the class of 2021. Before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge Mike Spaulding, the staff here at the amphitheater, Onondaga County, all of the high school administrative team, district office, for helping us to move this event only 8 days out. The class of 2021 surely deserved a fitting ceremony to draw a close to the 2021 school year and welcome their bright future. So we've come together tonight to honor the members of the Fayetteville-Manlius High School class of 2021 and to celebrate their success, their completion of course of study as prescribed by the state of New York for a high school diploma. They are ready to begin the next chapter of their lives, so let us begin. It's my pleasure to invite the class president of 2021, Ms. Lucy Fowler, to the podium to address her classmates.
Welcome, friends, parents, teachers, administration, staff, relatives, board members, alumni, and most importantly, the Fayetteville-Manlius class of 2021. I would like to thank everyone here tonight for your support and encouragement in making this incredible event possible. If some of you don't know, my name is Lucy Fowler, your Fayetteville-Manlius class president. Since this is my first live performance here at the Lakeview Amphitheater, I'll make sure I leave you with an act you will never forget. Soon, I can successfully say that my name may go down in history as one of the most famous people to have performed here on this very stage. So when I'm done, you can call me Zach Brown or Thomas Rhett, whatever you prefer. So considering this year we were jokingly planning on hosting all large events at home, catered by McDonald's, it's truly an honor to have this amazing opportunity to speak to you in person on behalf of this group of amazing students who, for the past 13 years, I have been proud to call my classmates, my teammates, and most importantly, my friends. When I was told back in April I had to come up with a 5 to 10 minute commencement speech, I thought, how could I possibly recap the past 13 years of our lives in 10 minutes? The answer is simple. I can't. But I can talk about our successes and our failures, our wins and our losses, our countless football games, school concerts, dance marathons, that first perfect score, or maybe even the first bad test grade, or the second bad test grade, or the third bad test grade, or maybe even the idea that good study habits are not established at 2:30 in the morning. I also thought about discussing how individuality is the key to success, but that idea was quickly taken off the table after the realization we're all sitting here in uniform rows wearing identical caps and gowns. So, let's take a look back to 13 years ago. Our journey together began as we each took our first steps on the kindergarten bus. Our parents, standing at the front door, nervously waving goodbye, thinking how fast we were growing up. Just yesterday, it felt like we were launching our fifth grade rockets, eagerly awaiting the hottest new deal at the book fair, traveling to Philadelphia and Boston for our final eighth grade farewell, or dangling on the Ender's Road spider webs for our life. Together, we have shared many wonderful memories, including the countless miles of walking solely for the pride and joy of our own foot token, the overwhelming anxiety after realizing your egg's broken in the annual egg drop, the phys ed classes filled with rainbow parachutes and jump ropes, the Halloween runway walk, that sliver of pizza you anticipate every holiday party, or the most intense and competitive day of your life, eighth grade field days. Through all the strange phases and not so trendy trends, we've stayed together and pulled through challenging times. Although COVID-19 physically separated us, after many months of being apart, our class was brought together, closer than ever. Distance taught us the values of our relationships, along with the appreciation for the times we spend together. We missed each other in many milestone events along the way, but I do believe that being apart taught us to value each other and the moments we share together. 3 weeks ago, our class was finally able to come together for the first time to celebrate one another on a beautiful June evening at the high school turf for our senior ball. Everyone was just ecstatic. We were all able to see one another, maskless, enjoying the final days of our high school career, together, in person. And now we are here together to celebrate our graduation, a moment that we have worked for 13 years. Take a moment, look around, truly. Look at this beautiful group of people here today. Our class, the Fayetteville-Manlius class of 2021, has defied the odds. We have made it to the final days of our high school career. Take these experiences. Take them and use them. Use them to become the best person you can possibly be. And use them to change the world. A good friend of mine, Beyonce, once said, don't talk about what you're going to do. Don't just dream about what you're going to do. Don't criticize somebody else for what you're not doing. You be it. Be about it. Be about that action and go do it. Keep your eye on your intention. Don't let any outside distraction or your own insecurity stop you from reaching your goals. Embrace that struggle. Surviving that struggle will strengthen you. This is a crucial time in our history and in our lives. The earth is ripping that Band-Aid off so we can really see our wounds, so we can acknowledge and nurture them. That's when the true healing begins. You can be that leader. You can lead the movement that celebrates humanity. My prayer for you is that you invest yourself and see the value of giving back and building your community the best way you can. Today, after 13 years, we are finally taking our last steps off the bus, with our parents at the front door waving goodbye. But this time, we start a new journey. A journey towards our futures, and leave behind an entire lifetime within the walls of the Fayetteville-Manlius School District. If there's one thing we can learn from this year, it's to realize what truly matters, how we choose to carry ourselves. We have felt the hardships of this pandemic, but our class, the Fayetteville-Manlius class of 2021, gets to decide how this ends. We have the opportunity to change the world, to rise up, and to make it ours. And after spending the past 13 years with you, I know the world is in good hands. On that note, welcome. Welcome the FM class of 2021. Welcome to the real world.
Each year, the number one student in the graduating class has the honor of addressing his or her classmates during the graduation ceremony. This year, I am pleased to invite Emma Cronenberg to the podium to address her classmates.
Class of 2021, to be honest, I had no idea where to begin this speech, where to begin this process of encapsulating 330 different stories, honoring each person's journey, celebrating what we have done both as individuals and as a class. I was honored to have this opportunity, but so humbled by the task that lay before me. I felt overwhelmed and lost. How could I possibly say everything that needed to be expressed? So, I did what any respectable person would do. I turned to Google for advice. After much research, I discovered a pattern among these speeches, a trend more common than silly bands. Most turn to famous quotes or well-known anecdotes to frame their speeches. Specifically, many discuss the book, All I Really Need to Know, I Learned in Kindergarten. But this is just not true. If I were to stand up on this podium and tell you that the keys to life were handed to us as we sat on those color block carpets stained with apple juice and goldfish crumbs, I would be saying that the subsequent 12 years were meaningless. These past 12 years have been anything but. Whether you were born and bred in Fayetteville-Manlius like I was, or you only recently became a Hornet, you still took this journey with us. Whether you decided to view high school as merely a stepping stone to Broadway, medical school, the moon, or you chose to invest yourself in everything high school has to offer, you are here. You are sitting in these chairs at this point where our diverse roads meet for maybe the last time. We have all taken different paths to get here. Sometimes they are freshly paved and we could coast along, our hair billowing in the breeze as we sang along to the playlists of our lives. Other times, the roads were made of gravel and were overgrown, our journeys obstructed by the randomness of nature and the lingering dust of others. We had to trek, to climb, walk backwards, or reevaluate our final destination. At these points especially, we look towards our family, our friends, and each other. These journeys were where we learned what we need to know, not when we were doe-eyed children perched on the starting line of life's great race, Not when our biggest pains were the scrapes on our knees from afternoons played out to the tune of the ice cream truck. Not when we were only learning what tools were available for us and not how to use them. Sure, we learned the golden rule, treat others the way you want to be treated. We added our names to the bulletin board announcing this pledge, then plastered our smiling, toothless faces beneath it. But we cannot truly understand the golden rule until we are faced with a test. Until we shake the hand of the point guard that beat us at States, compliment the girl who edged us out for first chair at All County, or converse with someone who doesn't share our views on the latest Stranger Things season or on the existence of God. We also learned that little seeds need water and sunlight to grow, but we didn't realize that we needed to fight for each seed, that its water was in danger and so was ours. We learned to wait our turn, and this was easy when it was merely a matter of waiting for that bathroom in the back of the classroom that never seemed to lock. But it's a whole different story when we're waiting for a right of way turning into tinderbox as the clock approaches 7:45. To once again feel the energy from the auditorium audience or the student section, or simply to hug our grandparents after months of isolation. We learned how to write by tracing the dotted lines, but we could not possibly have known the power that these words can hold, the ability of these letters to shape nations, express emotions, change others. We did not recognize that certain letters should never be strung together, and that other ones, like L-O-V-E, should always. We learned to put things back where we found them. Cleanup time was a dance as our peers shoved all the toys back into clear plastic bins. But what if the things we found were broken when they began? What if we had the ability to fix them through our actions, or at least begin to fix them? This we did not realize in kindergarten. We could not realize it until we recognized that the world is a lot more broken than we might like to think. Sometimes it's not only immoral but impossible to leave things how we found them. Sometimes we have to make a change. We, as individuals and as a generation, have already begun tackling this Herculean task. Finally, we learned how to wash our hands. But did any of us really sing happy birthday not once but twice before the global pandemic hit? This past year has been a speed bump upon all our roads, forcing us to slow down and to look around. It forced us to consider where we were along our own paths, how far we were from others and from ourselves. For some, this speed bump may have seemed insurmountable. For others, it was merely an anthill compared to the mountains we had just finished scaling. But no matter what you have already traversed, no matter how arduous or effortless, you are here. I am here. We are here. The roads endured and the miles trekked were necessary to bring us to this point, sitting together, although somewhat socially distant. So, celebrate this moment. I know I will. We should be proud of what we have accomplished and what we still have left to accomplish. We should be thankful of the compasses we've had along the way, the ones who have pointed us in the right direction, pulling us in with their love and support. My own compasses are my family, my dad and my sisters, Brooke, Tess, and Sarah. My mom is my northern star. We should be aware of the reasons we succeeded, the hiking boots given to us at birth, and the supplies already in our packs, as well as just the pure strength and dedication of ourselves. We should remember the roads that lay behind us fondly and critically, but never look back. I myself struggle with this. How am I supposed to say goodbye? How am I supposed to walk away when I know that our roads are only one-way streets? Nevertheless, it is time for these roads to diverge. It will not be easy. Change never is. But now we have even more tools in our backpacks than when we first started out. Survival skills that we can carry with us. We have the wisdom of our 13 years of education, plus all the lessons learned before we stepped on that yellow school bus so many years ago. We have the memory of our former selves and of each other. Just remember that there still lays a path ahead. There is still a journey to be made, hardships to be endured. There are still things to learn. No one ever wrote a book entitled, All I Really Need to Know I Learned in High School, because we never really learn everything we need to know. Our paths are always changing, and so are we. We are bound to struggle and to strive, to go off course and to trip over the shadows of our own future. We are bound to be blinded by both the thunderous rain and the incandescent sun. We are bound to walk hand in hand with others and then some point look around and realize that we must have let go along the line. Regardless, we must keep walking. Congratulations to the class of 2021 and all who helped you reach this juncture. Happy graduation.
This evening's music selection, entitled Bridge Over Troubled Water, will be performed by our senior choir members.
I'll be your bridge over troubled water. When you're down, I will carry you like a bridge over troubled water. I will lay me down.
It's now my pleasure to welcome Dr. Craig Tice, superintendent of the Fayetteville-Manlius School District, to the podium to offer some words and to introduce this year's commencement speaker.
Thank you, Dr. Kilmer. On behalf of the Board of Education, the school administration, and the faculty and staff of the Fayetteville-Manlius Central School District, I congratulate all of our graduates on a job well done. Each and every year, it is my pleasure as superintendent of schools to impart some sage advice and wisdom to our graduates before I have the distinct honor of introducing the faculty speaker for the commencement address. Given the recent COVID-19 pandemic, it would be very easy for me to craft my remarks to applaud your tenacity, adaptability, and perseverance in navigating what would be the end of your junior year and then your entire senior year, all while juggling the expectations of remote, hybrid, and in-person learning models. Needless to say, the past 15 months brought forth considerable challenges and obstacles that all of you had to overcome in order to reach today's finish line. You should be proud of all that you have accomplished. Yes, commencement is supposed to be a wonderful experience, but not today. Unfortunately, I feel compelled to apologize to all of you. I really tried to come up with something new and innovative for today's ceremony, but I realized I used up all of the good graduation quotes. Indeed, I exhausted all those clever and humorous commencement remarks, which helped to make this day memorable. All things considered, I knew I had to reach down deep in order to come up with something unique and creative, or I was going to have to give a used graduation speech. And trust me, there is nothing worse than a used graduation speech. I remember that same helpless feeling when I needed to go out and buy an anniversary card for my parents who were celebrating many of their wedding anniversaries. After scouring the shelves of a greeting card store, I could not find a card that said anything original. Simply put, I could not locate that special card which conveyed something which had not been said before. After all, they were married for 61 years, so this was quite a daunting task. As I was just about to give up hope, I found a card that at first glance appeared to be a thank you card amongst all of the anniversary cards on the shelf. Being a little obsessive compulsive, as I looked to the Board of Education, okay, a lot obsessive compulsive, I found myself needing to put the world back in some semblance of order. Come on. What kind of person previews a thank you card and then randomly places that greeting card back on the shelf in the anniversary card section of all places? How rude for us concrete sequential personalities. So I picked up the thank you card and was about to return it to where I thought it was its rightful place among all the other thank you cards on the adjacent shelf. I read the contents of the card and soon discovered that it was an anniversary card in disguise. The text of the card was written so that the card giver could express his or her gratitude to their parents for all that they have done over the years during their marriage. Ironically, it was exactly the type of card for which I was looking. I hope you feel the same way. As you graduate today in the midst of a pandemic, I ask you to be mindful and to thank your parents, guardians, and family members for their support over the years, but especially for their support over the course of the past year. Be sure to show your sincere appreciation to a teacher, an administrator, a coach who manage in less than ideal conditions. Don't be bashful about extending your gratitude to anyone who has helped you along the way. Even in the middle of the pandemic, all I ask is that you take time to show your gratitude to those who you love. I encourage you to continue to think and dream about all the possibilities that life has to offer. While the pandemic may cause some of us to focus on the negative, I know that many others have been introspective and grateful for all that they have in life. Even though you could choose to focus on all that you lost as a result of the pandemic, I implore you to celebrate and to be thankful for all that you've gained from your experience here at Fayetteville-Manlius. Go Hornets! With that said, it is now my distinct honor and privilege to introduce our keynote speaker. He is a distinguished educator and valued member of the faculty and a dedicated colleague who has taught many of you. He has encouraged you to be critical thinkers, to collaborate with others, to be effective communicators and creative problem solvers and lifelong learners. An Iraq War veteran who came to a career in education after his exemplary military service, which included two tours of duty, Mr. Aldrich can be counted on to inject tremendous energy and enthusiasm in his teaching and to make connections with his students on 11th grade access, Regents U.S. history, and participation in government. As for co-curricular activities, Ryan has served as one of the assistant coaches on the football team for the past 5 years, in addition to being the faculty advisor for the History Bee. A wannabe gentleman farmer, Ryan's family includes his wife, Erica, who teaches social studies at Eagle Hill Middle School. I am told that Ryan is a big New York Jets fan, and he aspires to be like the character Ron Swanson from the television show Parks and Recreation. As superintendent of schools, please know that I am still trying to reconcile that last piece of information with all of his impressive accomplishments. Mr. Aldrich is a graduate of Missinink Valley High School in downstate Orange County, and he holds a bachelor's and master's degree in history from SUNY Cortland. He is currently pursuing a second master's degree in military history from the Citadel. Last but not least, I was impressed when Ryan reached out to the district officials this spring in order to advocate for more outdoor learning spaces on our campuses. It seems the old adage, when life gives you lemons, you should make lemonade, resonated with Mr. Aldrich during the pandemic. Given the plethora of mask breaks and needing to teach lessons outside, Ryan saw the importance of creating additional outdoor learning spaces that could be incorporated into future long-range facility plans, and he wanted to share that information with others as they plan for future facility needs. He is always thinking ahead, and for that I am grateful. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Ryan Aldrich to deliver this year's commencement address.
Settle down now, we got stuff to do. All right. This is awesome, guys, first of all. Good evening, everyone. I'm glad to see everybody here, especially after the past year. And first, I'd like to thank the Board of Education, the administration, for doing everything that was necessary to make this happen. My fellow colleagues, thank you for a year to remember, to say the least. And finally, parents, guardians, and other important adults that are here with us today, thank you, because without you, none of these soon-to-be former students would be here. Class of 2021, it's been one heck of a ride, man, but you made it, and you helped put a year to remember in their history books. When Lucy first came and told me that I was voted to give this speech, I was extremely humbled, but also extremely nervous. I told her I had to think about it, right? You can ask her, right, Lucy? Yeah. And about after 5 minutes, I realized I was an idiot and ran down and told Ms. Hammond after I caught my breath that I would be honored to give this speech. And then I was trying to figure out why I was so nervous. I talk in front of you guys every day, right? I've given mission briefings to generals. I've led men in combat. I've rapped on the stage with Young Jock and Stephen Baldwin, right? And I don't tell you that stuff to brag. Well, the Stephen Baldwin part, kind of. It was really cool. But that's a story for after you graduate. It's a whole thing. But I tell you this stuff because that's how high of a regard I have for your class, and which presented me with another dilemma. What the heck did I want this speech to be about? I didn't know if I wanted it to be a speech filled with life lessons or the importance of history or just advice I wish I got when I was getting out of high school. One thing I know I wish I took more seriously is that life is hard, harder than most of you can imagine. Just ask your parents, they'll tell you. And like most things, they're right. Right? But you have to understand, you made it through this, right? And you, through your 4 years at FM High School, our society has gone through massive changes, both culturally, socially, and politically. But you've made it. You're not the first group that had to deal with these challenges, and you won't be the last. And the best thing you can do as a class is to leave this world better than you found it. Some believe you're not capable of taking on this burden. Well, they said the same thing about my generation. I'm a millennial. And they said the same thing about your parents' generation. And they said the same thing about your grandparents' generation. Prove them wrong, just like your parents and grandparents did. This is the time to be bold. Don't limit yourself. Take chances. That's all it takes to go from average to something else. Don't be afraid to go outside your comfort zone. You all have it in you. Let them tell you no. You don't have time to waste, people. Just think about how fast time goes. Right? Just think about this past school year. Just think back to freshman year. It goes by so quickly. That is why you have to be courageous. Your future is our future. So don't let the "are you still watching" become the regret of the past. And this seems heavy, because it is. Right? But you chose to accomplish this. Right? And you have to remember that when things seem insurmountable. This tells us something about our community, that together, with kindness and the willingness to help each other, we can get through anything. Hard times forge resilient people. And resiliency is one of the best character traits you can have in life. For those of you out there that think you aren't strong enough, you are. But you may not see it yet, but you are. You all have strengths. And as you go into this world, you have to find your strengths, find them, and play to them. When you're getting down and losing faith in yourself, which will happen, people, trust me, it does, you need to look to your past to find the strength and the motivation to carry on. It's not easy, and it's not anything in life really is. But you have to remember this year. Right? You made it through. You made it here. When I am struggling, I think of my mother. She's one of the strongest women I know. The lessons she has showed me throughout my life have always stuck with me. She told me grit, honesty, and kindness are just a few of the character traits my mother has instilled in me. The grit to keep going comes from my mom. My father passed away when I was 7 years old and left my mother with two boys and all the issues that comes with. As I started to get older, I started to talk to my mom as more of an adult, not as a kid, and you'll get there at some point. And I asked her, "How did you do it, raising two boys after all that?" And she looked at me and said, "I had no other choice. I just had to keep going." And I remind myself of that whenever I feel the odds are insurmountable. Just keep going. You need to find your own just keep going moment to help you and motivate you when you need it. My mother has always taught me to be honest with myself and others. Be honest with yourself as much as possible. Recognize your flaws, and then surround yourself with people that will help you overcome those flaws. Being honest with yourself is hard to do, but when you are, it makes life that much easier. Now, my mother's kindness was a little more subtle than her honesty sometimes, but it was always there. I try to be kind every day because that is what my mother taught me, and more importantly, showed me. I believe kindness, showing kindness whenever possible, is the best way to improve our society. Every day before leaving for high school, I asked my mother would tell me, "Do good." And so finally, one day, in that kind of smart aleck tone high school kids get with their parents, you all know about it, right? I asked my mom, "Ma, do good in what?" And she goes, "Everything." And that really left an impression on me. And it stuck with me all throughout my time in high school, to my time at war, to my time in college, to even right before I stood up here. I have always heard those two words in the back of my mind, do good. If you've had me in class, you know this because I say it every day when you're leaving. I've added my own little touch to it though. So to the Board of Education, the administration, and my colleagues, thank you for all your hard work this year. Parents, guardians, and important adults, again, thank you so much, because without you, truly none of this would be possible. And then finally, class of 2021, as you go out into this world and start a new chapter in your life, please do good things and be kind people. Thank you very much.
Okay, you're almost there. Almost there. I have a couple words for you. How many of you have younger siblings at home, maybe in elementary school? Quite a few. Yesterday was a pretty big day for them. What was yesterday? Well, it was the last day of school. How many of you have to have your photo taken the first day and last day of school every single year? Well, we have that tradition too. This is Wyatt. Wyatt's my second grader. And seeing his picture made me a little nostalgic. And I started looking through other pictures, looking for my older children, even when Wyatt was younger too. And then I found this one that had my oldest, who is going into first grade, and then one of the graduates here who is going into fourth grade. So you all were going into fourth grade. So I'm pretty sure that was about 2012. And then, on my better judgment, I started looking at some of my pictures from my childhood. I remember hating this. Every year, we had to take a picture in front of a pine tree in our front yard. My brother still loves to find these pictures. He sends them to me every once in a while, especially the more embarrassing ones, always making fun of the outfits I chose. I must admit, I laugh at many of these pictures, and I wonder why my parents let me dress myself. Really? White jeans? Like, what was I thinking? Besides laughing at myself, when I look at these pictures, they take me back and help me to remember the special times of my life. What I remember most are all the people that played a role in helping me chart a positive trajectory. Of course, they include my family, friends, many teachers, neighbors. But when I was young, I was moving so fast, I never took time to stop and reflect on such things. I think sometimes life moves at us so fast, at such a fast pace, we don't take time to appreciate all the gifts that are presented to us. I think for many of you, this year may have been a little different. As I watched and listened to you this school year, I noticed how reflective and appreciative you were for all those things you had prior to this pandemic. Our experiences these last 16 months forced us all to stop, reflect, and appreciate those many gifts we share. And so as we emerge from this challenging year and you start to be ready to begin to chart that path forward, I leave you with a few pieces of advice. First, you're in control of your path. You decide how you perceive the world around you. You decide how you respond to the gifts you receive and the challenges you face. Every one of you will be blessed by both. These gifts and challenges help to define our place in the world. So the question I have for you, will you work to better yourself and those around you? Will you embrace each experience life throws at you? Or will you be a passive victim of circumstance? Our time on this earth is limited. Don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your voice. Have a strong sense of self, embrace your values, feel comfortable with yourself and the decisions you make. Have a positive impact on others. Just as others have an impact on the trajectory of your story, just like they did on mine, you have an impact on the story of every person you come into contact with. You have to decide whether you will work to make those interactions positive ones. And sometimes it's hard. Living in a world where we focus on caring for one another instead of placing judgment is a world we will all find greater happiness in. Be kind. Being kind is not effortless. You must demonstrate honesty, sincerity, while forming genuine connections and relationships with others. Smile. You're in control of your attitude. Each day is full of endless possibilities. You just have to be present to see them. Walk down the street. Don't stare into the ground. Look people in the eye and smile. You'd be surprised how often you'd get one back, even with a mask on. People can always see and feel you smile. You don't know everything. You probably never will.
Don't walk through life thinking you have all the answers. The smartest people I know spend more time asking questions than announcing answers. Spend your life seeking to understand. Live in the present. Don't be overwhelmed by the thought of the future, nor weighed down by the past. Take time to enjoy every step on your path. Place family first. Take time to look at those old pictures and reflect on your path, your journey here. No matter where you go, remember to always keep close to you your family and friends. They are your greatest resource and supporters in good times and in bad. You're here today because of the support that your family and friends have provided along the way. Lastly, I hope you look back at your time at FM and be proud of yourself, be proud of your school district, for we are proud of each of you. Congratulations, class of 2021. It's time. At this time, I will ask students in Section A to come forward to receive their diploma covers.
Lily Marie Abbott. Ziad Sammy Abdul Malak. Samifa Adavi Kalanu. Simal Ahmad. Saif Eldin Tamer Ahmed. Alexis An. Miguel Angel Aldana. Jack Francis Altamanda. Catherine Grace Amico. Daniel Arafiev. Connor Michael Aspinall. Luke Michael Asimon. Yeah. Nina Elizabeth Avery. Seth Adam Bailey. Karina Yvonne Balian. Eric Gregory Bang. Brianna Janae Barnes. Zachary Robert Barnhart. Kylie Hope Beam. Elise Ruth Beckman. Ethan Aaron Bira. Matthew Ian Bem. Kashyup Sai Bendapuri. Max Logan Benjamin. Ethan Tal Bird. Riley Eckerson Bissetta. Grace Catherine Bloom. Layla Borsillo. Ava Burugierdi. John Eric Bauer. Sarah Frances Bryan. Abby Doreen Brown. Ian Austin Brown. Alia Nicole Serrani. Lance Michael Budgen. Juliana Noel Buenafilio. Dimitra Karitsis Kappers. Ariana Ray Karen. Jamie Lynn Case. Maya Elizabeth Chaikin. Joyce Chen. Gabriel Lewis Cisanetti. Sumara Roya Chaudhry. Zachary Cole Coelho. Finn Cohen. Catherine Elaine Cole. Christina Lee Coleman. Jillian Jane Margaret Coleman. Emma Grace Colici. Daniel Philip Comer. Edward Warren Cook III. Lydia Marion Coombs.
Zaire Jalen Warren Coor. Zoe Sophia Costanza. Isabel Stephanie Crovella. Aiden Nicholas D'Ambrosio. Hallie Nicole Dano. Anthony James Durin. Jaden Patrick Davis. Gemma Nicole Decker. Sarah Marissa DeCros. Jackson Randall Denton. Sawyer Mitch Darashinsky. Allison Ann DiMicelli. Ima Yurim Din. Tori Dolores Dixie. Ian Nicholas Donella. Danielle Downey. Braden Quinn Downs. Ronan Michael Drozd. Alexander Daniel Duggleby. Madeline Brooke Duggleby. James Edmund Jurgis. Julia Ann Ignazik. Jesse May Eisenhut. Sam Ali Albadawi. Kendra Elizabeth Elliott. Sarah Elzorkani. Ryan Robert Everding. Madison Brinley Ewert. Benjamin Thomas Farber McEntee. Cyrus Tunson Felton. Kirsten Ann Fielding. Patrick David Finnegan. Matthew Amato Fiorentino. McKenna Jane Florzik. Madeline Esther Fosick. Lucille Grace Fowler. Hannah Murphy Fox. Isaac Vincenzo Frechette. Sadie Dale Fridley. Olivia Grace Frank. Peyton Edward Gira. Valentino Giuseppe Gibson. Claire Julia Grenis. Olivia Shea Grossbeck. Alan Robert Hamilton. Mabel Ann Hance. Justin Prescott Hanover. Mia Catherine Harris. Luke Andrew Hasenwinkel. Virgil Prider Haslam Ransom. Lindsay Rose Hawthorne. Daniel Patrick Hongs.
Lauren Bailey Hayes. Lindsay Elizabeth Hebert. Sophia Dylan Hefner. Andrew Mark Heyman. Amanda Claire Hibbard. Ryan Douglas Hill. Sarah Susan Hills. Chloe Elizabeth Hodge. Sedala Monet Horton. Victoria Marie Horton. Anya Maureen Hoy. Tania Roshar. Samuel Higgum Hughes. Benjamin Matthew Hutz. Alethea Marie Aida. Ronan Ingersoll. Gavin Woodward Isley. Yulia Vladislavovna Ivanova. John Noel Jeffrey. Adam John Jernigan. Danielle Marie Jones. Audra Grace Johnson. Hannah Lauren Kazarowski. Grace Eleanor Kircher. Samantha Grace Kellish. Thomas William Kellish. Tamana Khatri. Owen Isaac Kimbrough. Catherine Fanny Carmella Klein. Joshua Elliot Kohlbrenner. Julia Elizabeth Kohlbrenner. Adrian Kopeck. J. Axel Quarter. Andrew Joseph Koster. Emma Grace Cronenberg.
Madison Ann Kraus. Jennifer Prather Kruger. Evan James Krugen. Liam Jameson Kurek. Matthew Donovan McComb. Morgan Olivia Lefex. Nathan Francis LaRocca. August Eugene Larson. Gavin Richard Latta. Sophia Donna Latoff. Jasmine Lawrence. Amanda Rose Leary. Madison Ray Lemery. Megan Falso Leonard. Albert Harrison Levy. Annie Lee. Hannah Yueyi Lee.
Aiden Stanton Liddell. Sophia Lynn. Charles Jung-Soo Lo. John Anthony Lorraine. Taylor Jane Luxinger. Caitlin Nicole Ludwig. Zachary Michael Lugert. John Hoffman Lutz. Hannah Rose Madden. James Patrick Medill. Michael Charles McGee. Sydney Lynn Marr. Kevin James Malone. Alessandra Marie Menicone. Alexandra E. Marcinkowski. Abigail Angeline Maring. Miles Kenneth Thomas Marnie. Paige Marie McAndrew. Gerard Benjamin McCrowan. Erin Ann McDowell. Luke Tripoli McEwen. Logan Todd McIntosh. Max William McKee. Sarah Grace McMorris. Elijah Luke McNaughton. Fiona Mexico. Jacob Allen Merrow. Joshua Philip Michael. Jack Martin Middleton. Luke Jeffrey Middleton. Paul Samuel Miller. Shayla Kathleen Miller Denny. Chase Tier Montgomery. Tristan Alexander Moore. Daniel Amon Musa. Caitlin Marie Mullally. Emily Victoria Muller. Paige Kennedy Murphy. Hashim Naeem. Morgan Marie Napier. Amaya Rose Nash. Callum Shaylin Newton. Katiana Malene Noble. Jack Clements Nusserino. Aiden Towns Nugent. Amoge Justina Nwaketi. Jacob Gordon O'Connor. Ryan Thomas O'Neill. Ijoma Oko.
Lucy Gibson Alcott. Yeah! Luna Katrine Oley. McKenna Catherine Oley. Matthew Charles Osterhout. Catherine Emma Ottaviano. John Michael Uyong. Joshua Ari Ovedia. Colin William Owens. Francesco Onofrio Pagano. Aaron Nicole Palacios. Celine Jason Poliakra. Michaela Isabella Papa. Benjamin Storm Parrish. James Scott Peden. James Joseph Perkovich. Jack Robert Perry. Rory Grace Fall. Catherine Nicole Pizanka. Leo Andrew Peoples. Joshua Josan Pitcher. Jennifer Marie Poole. Sarah O'Shea Poole. Audrey Lynn Pratt. Paris Alexa Pusha.
Way to go, Paris.
Marina Shea Purdy. Elizabeth Ann Pitello. Samantha Fair Pin. Jerry Shanshu Kwan. Natalia Jasmine Quiñones Franco. Samuel Cheney Rabin. Isabella Rose Randolph. Colin Michael Raymond. Sadie Grace Rayner. Michael Lawrence Rikus. Thank you. Sarah Rose Reisman. Sally Elizabeth Reynolds. Ransom Pratt Reynolds IV. Julia Castelnova Richardson. Katrina Marie Rivera. Sammy Rizzo. Lexi Catherine Rowe. Brandon Paul Rogers. Sky Rolnick. May Elizabeth Ruddy. Damian Andrew Russell. Caitlin Elizabeth Sansone. Maeve Margaret Schefter. Kara Lynn Shem. Helena Isabel Schmidt. Lisa Hope Schramm. Daniel Scott Schrilla.
Claire Elizabeth Schroeder. Toby Max Schulman. Chase Elizabeth Sedlak. Megan Alexis Seidberg. Emma Elizabeth Saraluca. Kevin Shang. Nicole Yanza Shanguia. Kyuhyun Shim. Lydia Lynn Schuler. Carlina Michelle Sedello. Matthew Alexander Sikorsky. Jameson Halley Slade. Alexis Namie Smith. Hannah Shinling Snow. Claire Ann Snyder. Itai Spinoza. Alexandria Nicole Stevenson. Harper Elizabeth Stoppaker. Luke Edward Stratton. Andy Bo Sun. Lucas James Tabor. Bryn Elizabeth Taylor. Jackson David Taylor. Owen Patrick Taylor. Ty Timothy Thielen. Sophia Nicole Tenike. Kristen Therese Truman. True Vesta Uzatinsky. Benjamin James Vallée. Kelsey Gail Vest. Logan Dalen Wahlberger. Abigail Ryman Walkett. Kate Emma Walters. Lucas DeFlorio Wires. MJ Wedding. Liam Curtis White. Connor Ryan Wysorek. Allison Elizabeth Wild. Logan John Wilkinson. Samuel Martin Wilkes. Jacob Eric Wing. Camilla Wojtyczewicz. Sophie Bailey Woodridge. Megan Marie Wright. Caden James Yancey. Caroline Hain Yee. Nina Zhang. Charlotte Eddie Zinniger. Rebecca Madeline Ziobro. Emma Ann Zog. Isabel Zoe Zuber.
Okay, class of 2021, could you please rise? Class of 2021, please move your tassel from right to left. It is with great pleasure that on behalf of Dr. Tice, the Board of Education, I declare you to be graduates of Fayetteville-Manlius High School. Now, it is tradition that we end our ceremony with the alma mater, but since I started my speech with talking about pictures, can I do a selfie? Yeah. On the back of your programs, you will find the words to our alma mater. Not that you need them. All right, graduates, I need to hear you. I'm going to get you started. Ready? Guarded by... On behalf of our entire community here at Fayetteville-Manlius, we wish you well. Good luck, graduates. Thank you, everyone.